Hi, welcome to Savi's Fashion Studio. My name is Savita. In this class, I'll show you how to make this cute denim handbag, which is stylish and handy and has a zipper and magnetic button closure. This is easy to make. Due to the current COVID-19 situation, we should not be going out. So you can use or repurpose your old jeans or denim skirt fabric, or you can use any thick cotton fabric. I'll guide you step by step. So let's start. First of all, let's see what are the materials we need for this project. Apart from the sewing machine, I'm using this thick denim fabric of Arvin Mills. The width of this fabric is 31 inches, and for this project, I need 1/2 meter of fabric. You need the pattern pieces, which you need to cut on fabric. If you want, you can make the pattern or you can directly cut it on fabric. You need your marking tools, the measuring tape, your cutting tools, a rotary cutter and a cutting mat or fabric shears. Instead of pins, this fabric weight is convenient to use when you're working with thick fabrics. You need a zipper which is 13 inches long. This is a hard plastic board. This is optional. This is to stiffen the base of the bag, which I'll explain later. Two sets of magnetic snap buttons. I'm also using this Made by Me label, which we have specially made for our students, which they can use in their projects. So let's start. First of all, let me explain the pattern. You can make the pattern on paper or you can directly cut it on fabric. So you would need 4 pieces to make this bag. This is piece 1, 2, 3 and 4. Piece 1, you need to cut 18 inches long and 8 inches wide. This includes the seam allowance of 1/4 inch all around. You need to cut one of this on fabric. The second piece is 13.5 inches long and 3 inches wide, including the seam allowance. You need to cut 2 of these on fabric. Third piece is 12.5 inches long and 3.75 inches wide. You need to cut 2 of this on fabric. And the fourth piece is 8 inch long and 7 inch wide. You need to cut 2 of this on fabric. So all these 3 pieces, you need to cut 2 on fabric, and this is just 1. So once you have this pattern, cut all the pieces individually and then place it on fabric and cut the fabric, or you directly do this on fabric. So the piece 1, we just need 1 in fabric. I've already cut it. So this is 1/2 meter of fabric. After you cut the first piece, fold the fabric as rest of the pieces needs to be cut in 2. This is 2 layers of fabric. So I'll be cutting the second and third piece here. Now with the remaining fabric, you can fold it this way so that you can get 2 of the fourth piece, that is 8 inch long and 7 inch wide. So you can get that here. First, overlock all the raw edges and then we'll be starting to sew. This is piece 2. This fabric is smooth on one side and rough on the other. This rough side is the wrong side. So we'll be folding on wrong side. Fold the fabric in center. To lightly crease it, iron. Once you've got the center line, fold from either side. And press. And do the final fold. Now we'll be stitching at the edge on either side. Do the same for the other piece. Fold it to the wrong side and do it the similar way. These two pieces are for the bag handle. So keep it aside. Then take piece number 3. One of the long sides has half an inch seam allowance. So fold half inch and press. Do the same on this side. So this folded side is where we'll be attaching the zipper. So we'll be placing it in this way. So we'll be sewing at the edge and sewing 1 centimeter apart. Now take the pieces numbered 4 and from top mark 2 1/4 inch. I'm marking on the wrong side. Do the same on the other side. And we'll be marking on the other piece as well. On one of these pieces, I'm stitching this label. I marked around 2 1/4 inch down from the edge and the center. So I'll be sewing on both sides here. So let's start sewing. You would also need your zipper foot. First, I'll prepare the handle for the bag by sewing on both edges. You can use your regular presser foot to do this. I'll be using this edge stitching foot to sew the edges, which makes it very easy. However, I'll make a detailed video on this some other time. You can also use your regular presser foot. Just briefly, I'll explain about this edge stitching foot. If you see here, this leg of the foot is higher than the other side. So when you align the fabric to this leg of the foot, automatically it sews to the edge. So you don't need to mark where you need to stitch. You just need to align it to this part. And you get this in different sizes. So this is 1/16. That is, you get the stitch 1/16 from the edge. You will get 1/2 inch and 1/4 inch and different sizes in this, which I'll be showing in my next video. So I'll stitch here and again stitch on the other edge. We'll be doing for both these straps. Lock at the beginning. I'm sewing on my Juki Industrial DDL 900B sewing machine. So the straps are done, keep it aside. Now I'm sewing the label on one of the side pieces. I marked around 2 1/2 inches down because we'll be sewing the handle here. And I've centered the label. I'll be just sewing on both sides. I locked, stitch and lock. Same on the other side. So this is done. I'll keep it aside. Now take the pieces for which we'll be attaching the zipper. Now for these pieces, we had folded 1/2 inch and pressed it on both sides. Now keep this zipper in the center. And we'll be sewing at the edge. And again, sew another line of stitch 1 centimeter away. Now while placing the pieces on the zipper, make sure once you've stitched, it will match with the width of this piece. That's the side piece. I'm placing the piece little away from the zipper coil. After sewing the zipper, the width of this and the width of the side piece should match. Now I'll change to the zipper foot. As you come closer to the slider, it's difficult to sew. So lift the presser foot with the needle inside the fabric and slide this down so that you can continue stitching. Now do another stitch 1 centimeter away and then do the same for the other side. After attaching the zip, take the fabric piece numbered 4. On right side, we had marked 2 1/4 inch in from the edge on both sides. Now take the longest piece, that is piece number 1. place it right on right, aligning the edge to the 2¼ inch mark, and we'll be sewing 1/4 inch in from the edge. Lock at the beginning and start sewing. When you reach the corner here, stop 1/4 inch in from the edge, and then we'll be turning this piece to this side and continue stitching, and again we'll be turning this to the other side and continue stitching. The other edge should again meet at 2¼ inch mark. Lock at the end. Let me show while sewing. I'm using a 1/4 inch edge stitching foot. Lock at the beginning. When you come to the corner, you will need to turn this fabric in this way and continue sewing. When it is 1/4 inch away from the edge, put the needle in and turn. Again, align the edges together. Make sure there is no pleat formed. Why we just keep 1/4 inch seam allowance here is, if you keep more, that is maybe 1/2 inch, when turning it becomes difficult, you will not be able to avoid this pleat. So you need to keep only a 1/4 inch seam allowance all around here. Again, before reaching the end, just 1/4 inch away from the edge, stop with the needle inside the fabric and then turn the fabric. Lock at the end. So I've sewn all around and reached the other 2¼ inch mark that we made on the side piece. I've locked, and at this stage, this is how your project would look. Now, this edge of the longest piece needs to be attached to the other side piece. So place it right on right, and again from this edge and from this edge mark 2¼ inches. Same like we did for the other side piece, and align the edge of the longest piece to that 2¼ inch mark and sew all around, same as we did for the other side. So we'll be starting from here. At this corner, turn the long piece and reach the other corner. Again, turn the long piece and you'll be reaching the 2¼ inch mark on the other side of the side piece. Now I'm stitching the other side. Again, I've marked 2¼ here. I place the longest piece aligned to that marking and align the edges. When you sew, if the long piece is facing you or on top, it's easier to turn in the corners. So we'll be sewing it 1/4 inch from the edge. Lock at the beginning. Just 1/4 inch before reaching the end, stop with the needle inside. Then lift the presser foot and turn, and turn this fabric. Align the edges again. Keep everything flat. Just focus on the edges here and make sure there are no pleats. I've read the other marking here. Now lock at the end. So once you've done this, this is how your bag would look like a basket. Now we'll be attaching the handles here on the side piece. To attach the handles, I'm marking 1 inch in from the edge on the side piece and on the other side as well. Place the handle on that marking and sew it 1/4 inch and turn it and place the other end on the other marking and sew it 1/4 inch. Do the same with the other handle, attaching it to the other side piece. As it is very thick, if it's difficult to move, slightly lift the presser foot as you're sewing. do the same for the other side. I'll place the strap here and sew in the same way as we did for the other side. Now put the handle inside and take the zipper piece, place it right side facing inside. All the wrong sides are on the outer side. Now align these edges. You'll be sewing at 1/4 inch all around. So if you're starting from here, lock, stitch, and when you come here where the side piece joins to the center piece, fold the seam towards the center and continue sewing. Align the edges together. Sew it 1/4 inch. When you come to this side seam, fold it towards the center and sew over the seam. And when you come to the corner, put the needle in, lift the presser foot and turn. So you're sewing all around with 1/4 inch seam allowance. So let's start. So the handle is inside. I'm placing this right on right and start from this edge. Sewing it 1/4 inch in from the edge. Lock at the beginning. It might be a little difficult here because of the multiple layers. Do it slowly. Even here, you need to do it slowly. If the needle hits the zipper teeth, the needle may break. So you can turn the hand wheel and do it slow. When you have reached the corner, 1/4 inch in from the edge, stop with the needle inside the fabric, lift the presser foot and turn. Now align the other side. When you are sewing the other side, you will come across this side seam. You just straighten it and align the edge of the zipper piece to the edge of the side. Now when you come to this seam, just flatten it and place the edges together. Now align the rest of the fabric. If you are taking the correct seam allowance, the edges should match. Now when I continue sewing, you see the side seam, this is how it will be. You just straighten it and align the edges together. The seam is folded towards the center. Stop when it is 1/4 inch in from the edge and turn. Continue the same way on the other side. Again, there's a zipper here. Carefully sew. So I've sewn all around. Now open the zipper and turn right side out. And push the corners well. You can use something blunt to push the corners. Push out all the corners. Now the only thing remaining is the magnetic snap buttons on both sides. To attach the snap buttons, mark around 1/2 inch in from the edge. On all four corners. the distance is 1 centimeter. Using a seam ripper, just make small cuts, very small cuts, just for this to enter. Don't cut too much. Push this inside. Then turn to the wrong side. Put this and then press this well so that button is attached. Now it is secure and it won't come off. Do the same for the other side. And on the opposite side, we'll be using the other part of the button. So the buttons are attached. The bag is complete. Now when you place something inside the bag, the base may sag. So to avoid that, there is something we can do, which is optional, which I'll be showing now. This is a stiff plastic board to give stiffness to the base of the bag. So you can cover this with the fabric and place it inside. So this prevents base from sagging when you put things inside the bag. I've cut 6x7 of this plastic board and covered it with the nylon fabric, which I'll be using as a base for this bag. Thanks for watching this class. Please stay home and stay safe.